that we're tracking here on headlines today. Prime Minister Narendra Modi finds a mention in a 9-minute video that's been put out by Al-Qaeda, the latest by its operational wing in the Indian subcontinent. Of course, headlines today cannot independently vouch for the authenticity of this video that's been made available to us. Now, 7 minutes into this new terror propaganda video, Al-Qaeda chief, and his name is Asim Umar, he is the subcontinent chief, makes a big pronouncement on the crusade against Islam, alleged crusade against Islam by the US, World Bank, drone attacks, Charlie Hebdo, United Nations, and Narendra Modi's speeches. This video, produced by Al-Qaeda's own Al Sahab Video Production House, is the latest in a string of videos that reveal that Al-Qaeda's move to recruit new operatives from the subcontinent. The formation of the new affiliate, Al-Qaeda Indian Subcontinental, or AQIS, was announced by the overall leader of Al-Qaeda, Ayman al-Zawahiri, last year. Now, this video, which is essentially a long and a violent list of Al-Qaeda's so-called achievements over the years, is clearly an attempt to counter the growing influence of ISIS, the Islamic State, in Iraq and Syria. Experts believe that the video is definitely representative of Al-Qaeda's desperation to recruit more people to match the ongoing effort by ISIS and other terrorist groups, and especially in the subcontinent. Joining me now with the latest is headlines today's Deputy Editor for Strategic Affairs, Shiv Arur. Shiv, you've been tracking this video very closely. The reference to Narendra Modi, the reference to Prime Minister Narendra Modi, is indicative of clear and present danger. Closer home, Shiv.
Absolutely. Clear and present danger closer home, Gaurav. And also, according to the several experts we've been speaking to and those who've commented on this particular video that came out just a few days ago, Gaurav, that this is obviously a recruitment drive. Remember that the Al-Qaeda is a diminished force in many ways with the rise of the Islamic State in Iraq and Syria and several other factors, including, a complete failure to decentralize post Osama's death in 2011. Has led to a huge diminishment in the potency of the Al-Qaeda, especially in the AFPAC region as well as in the Middle East. And therefore, to try and counter the rise of the ISIS, to try and sort of re-energize, rejuvenate its operations in that particular area as well as in North Africa, the attempt is to rejuvenate its recruitment process. Now, remember, we've seen intelligence reports over the last 2 years that have referred to the ISIS as well as the Al-Qaeda as far as their intentions, their operations, their recruitment drives within the Indian subcontinent are concerned, Gaurav. But this video shows that the Al-Qaeda is looking very much to try and revive its efforts in the Indian subcontinent, in Bangladesh, in Pakistan, in Nepal, in other in India, in Sri Lanka, even to try and find new ways to recruit more people, because obviously that's going to be the fuel of future operations, especially in Iraq and Syria, where it's where its power has been almost entirely eroded by the rise of the ISIS. So this video is obviously only the latest in a long list of efforts. Obviously, this is only one part of it. The video is only one part of what is obviously a much larger effort, but it's something that is being taken very serious note of by Indian agencies.
Now, as far as Indian agencies are concerned, just a short while back, we had some senior intelligence officials who felt that ISIS control or ISIS trying to spread its tentacles across India wasn't succeeding. An odd case here and there, but ISIS wasn't succeeding. What about Al-Qaeda and especially the money that comes in with such recruitment, Shiv?
Well, there's no doubt about the fact, like you just referred to the fact that Indian agencies have said that there have been odd attempts here and there, but no sort of no blanket success by any of these groups. At the same time, Gaurav, as we've been reporting on each one of these cases, whether it's in Karnataka or in Maharashtra, whether it's on the west on the west coast, where there is a hotbed of recruitment effort that's actually happening, each of these cases could flare up into something much more serious. So even on a case-to-case basis, ISIS. The efforts being made by ISIS and Al Qaeda to actually recruit Indians is something that simply cannot be brushed off as something that's happening sporadically, because it could very easily reach a criticality, a critical point where things become much, much worse. There are pockets of discontent across the country that these groups are looking to actually manipulate and to stir up, not only in the Northeast but also in Jammu and Kashmir as well, where we've even seen ISIS flags being raised. We're seeing Pakistan flags being being hoisted on a regular basis at rallies there. ISIS flags have been raised in South Kashmir as recently as 4 to 5 weeks ago. So obviously this is something that these groups take a very, very clear note of. As far as Indian intelligence agencies and security agencies are concerned, each one of those incidents, whether it is Kalyan, whether it is in Bengaluru, whether it's anywhere else, there have been ISIS threat letters that have surfaced against the RSS in Chennai as well. All of these are being taken with hopefully the maximum seriousness that they actually require, because these are groups that mean business when they're talking about actually identifying areas of discontent and manipulating them for their own gains in the Middle East.
Shiv Arour, for the moment, many thanks for joining me.